Hey everyone, we're going to take a quick look today at the DataStax Astra provider for Terraform, talk a little bit about what it is and what it can do for you and your infrastructure as code. And so if you're not familiar with Terraform, Terraform has become the de facto industry standard for infrastructure as code. It allows you to define your infrastructure in configuration files and let Terraform manage the state of that remotely on your cloud provider environment, in our case, Astra. And so let's take a look at how we go about doing that. The first thing you need to do to get working with this is install Terraform. You can check out the Terraform documentation to learn how to do that on your particular platform. Terraform is a tool that's installed locally. And so we already have it installed here on our OS. And so you can just run a quick check to see what you've got. We've got the latest version installed here. And so that's what we're going to work with. And so what the Terraform provider does is it allows Terraform a way to plug into the remote infrastructure. And so with the release of the DataStax Astra provider for Terraform, now you can manage the infrastructure that you would have otherwise been doing manually through the DataStax Astra web console, or perhaps through some of our public APIs. You can do those through Terraform. And so let's take a look at how we do that. To get started, the first thing you're going to need is a provider file. And so we're going to create a provider.tf file. And in there, what we're going to do is grab a little snippet from here and talk a little bit about what that does. And so this file really defines for Terraform kind of what it needs to do the job you're going to ask it to do. In our case here, we're telling it that we're going to use the DataStax Astra provider that we're talking about. We're going to need to inject a variable called token, and we'll talk a little bit about that here in a second. And so once we've got this in place, we can go ahead and do a Terraform init to get our project up and going. And so what you'll see happens here is that the Terraform initializes some pieces that it's going to use to manage state and persist state locally so that it can manage the remote resources to match that state. So now we've got that in place. Let's talk a little bit about what we can then deploy. In Terraform, there are two basic abstractions to understand, and the majority of what we'll work with here. The first is the resource. The resource represents the element on the remote infrastructure that you're actually going to create. In our case, the database. The other abstraction in play here are data sources. Data sources represent a way for Terraform to query the remote endpoint to get state about those resources. And if you come to the DataStax Astra provider documentation found out here on the Terraform registry, you can kind of get an idea of what resources we have and also what data sources are available for you to use. So you'll see a number of different resources that we can manage. We'll be talking just about two simple ones today, the database and the key space. So let's jump right into that. So to actually deploy some of these resources, we're going to create another file called our resources.tf. And in here is where we're going to define the resources that we actually want Terraform to manage. Let's grab another little snippet of code and we'll talk about what this is going to represent. So we're going to put this into our resource.tf file. And what it's going to define is that we want Terraform to deploy an Astra database, the resource that our provider talks about over here. You can see the documentation for that. It's going to give it a local name of demo one. We'll talk about how that's relevant here in a minute when we go to create other resources related to this piece. Remotely, it's going to be called demo database one. We're going to create a key space within that called key space one. And we want it deployed to US East one within GCP. Simple as that. So now what we're going to do is come back down to our command line. And this time we're going to do a Terraform apply. And what this is going to tell Terraform to do is go out and create the resources that we've defined here. To do that, the first thing we need is a token. So let's go into to the Astra web console and grab a token. We need this for authorization purposes. So we're in our org here. We're going to go to organization settings. We're going to go to token management. And we're going to select a role for the token. This could be any role that gives you the permissions that are necessary for the operations you're trying to create. We're just going to grab a quick built-in role and get rolling. What we need is the token from here. So we're going to copy this token. We're going to throw that in a temp file real quick, just so that we don't lose it. Grab that, and we're going to go back and give it to Terraform. All right, so now it has what Terraform has, what it will need to be able to authenticate with the APIs on Astra, which it's going to use to actually manage this resource. So before it actually makes the change, Terraform's going to prompt you to check out what you just told it to do. And what we just told it to do was create an Astra database with the name database one, key space one, in US East one on GCP. So everything looks good here. We're going to go ahead and say yes and let Terraform start to create that deployment for us. And so you'll see it's been here, and this is where the provider starts to take over. Terraform's using the provider to leverage APIs within Astra to enact the changes that we wanted, that we asked for here. It's going to use that authentication token we just talked about as well, and work from there. So let's go back over to the web console and take a look at what we see actually happening. So the provider is going to, you see over here on the command line, the provider is going to continuously check for state to make sure that it has, the remote resource has reached the state that we have asked it to be in. And so you'll see over here in the console, while that's still spinning, that the database has started up. We've got demo database one as we expect it, and it's in the pending state. It's not yet up available, and that's why you're still seeing it checking status over here. So this will take just a second for the database to come up, and then we can check and make sure that that's where we want it to be state-wise. See that Terraform has taken care of deploying what we asked it to. If you take a look, dig a little bit deeper here, you can see that we've got our demo database one, it's in Google Cloud and US East one, and we've got the key space that we wanted there. We'll go ahead and start talking about the next phase of things while we wait for this to completely wrap up and make the database fully available. So the other resource that we want to talk about here is the key space. And so we're going to actually add an additional key space to that database that we just created. Let's grab the snippet for that and talk a little bit about how that works. So back in our resource file, we're going to now add a new bit defining a new resource. Here, we're going to define an Astra key space. It's going to locally be called demo key space 2. And also remotely, it's going to be called that as well. What's interesting here is that you can see that it requires a database ID. In the example over here on the docs, we're using the full ID of the database. You could do that. You can also let Terraform manage some of this for you. And so we've actually got this variable reference here, Astra database demo1.id. And what that's going to do is it's going to reference the resource, the remote resource that was defined by Astra database demo1, and grab the ID. And when we apply that, you'll see how Terraform actually injects that full ID for us without us having to go and grab it. So you can automate all of this within Terraform itself. So let's jump back over to the Astra console, and you can see here that the database is now active and everything has come up and it has its ID right here. And so let's go and apply our key space change. So we're going to do just another Terraform apply. And it's going to ask you again for the token. Let's grab that. All right. And once again, it's going to kind of, we're going to let it prompt to show us what was going to be created. Here's where it injected the ID. You can see it's going to create one new resource, and that resource is going to be an Astra key space. And you can see here where originally we had this variable injection for database ID. It has gone ahead and injected that ID. And so you can see that it took the ID from that you see over here on Astra and it injected it here. So key space two now should get created within this database here. So we'll go ahead, that all looks correct. We'll say yes, we'll let Terraform apply that. And now over within Astra, we will see that we get a new key space. And you just saw it pop in there. We've got demo key space two now. So we have the two key spaces that we created. The first one came from our original database creation and then adding the subsequent key space afterwards. And what was interesting was Terraform knew that it already had the remote database deployed. So when we went for the second stage, all it did was deploy the key space itself. That is the state management Terraform is doing locally for you. And that wraps up what we wanted to demonstrate today. If you have other questions, interest in the project, you can check out more from the documentation on the Terraform registry. There's examples, etc., for how you can use the different resources. And if you're interested, you can also check out the source code and get involved in the project over on GitHub. Thanks very much.